Hey guys, my name is Ashwin and welcome to our YouTube show. So this is a YouTube show that's made by me and Ankur. We have been working on a wide variety of projects like documentaries, fiction films and ads and all of those things. We have been taught by a lot of people, like there are a lot of teachers from our film school times, a lot of people whom we have assisted, a lot of people from whom we got to learn and all of those things. We have friends with whom we share all of these thoughts and things. But we thought, why can't we push that boundary and share it with a lot more people? So that's how the idea of this YouTube show came up. And so, yeah. If you have ever clicked a photo or a video on a DSLR, on a mirrorless, or on a mobile phone, or any of the equipments on which you can take a photo or a video, you would have come across the term called ISO. And there is a lot of buzz going around telling that ISO is the sensitivity of a sensor, and there are a lot of people who tell that ISO is an organization and all of those things. So even I used to believe that ISO is the sensitivity of the sensor, and then I understood that it's all wrong. It's not any of those things. It's something that's completely different. To understand what ISO is, we have to first understand how an image is formed in a digital camera. So in a digital camera, what happens is light or light energy passes through the lenses and comes and hits the sensor to form the image. So when this light energy passes through the lens and hits the sensor, what happens is this light energy is converted into electrical signals or electrical energy, and this electrical energy is then converted into digital data, which is the zeros and ones. This data is what is saved into your memory cards or your it's fed into the displays that you see, etc. This is the process how an image is formed in a digital camera. Where ISO comes into play is where the electrical signal is converted into the digital data. When this conversion happens, a small amount of amplification is given to this data to amplify it or to increase it of sorts. Let's look at an example of a mic and a speaker system. So there what happens is when you talk to a mic, your sound energy or your sound is getting converted into electrical energy, and this electrical energy is then converted into again sound energy through the speaker. As you increase the volume on the speaker, the sound that is going out from the speaker is going to increase. And as you decrease the volume, the sound is going to decrease. This is kind of the same idea that happens with the ISO also. So there is the signal, and as you increase the ISO, the amount of amplification is increased, and as you decrease it, the amplification is decreased. And what happens exactly when you increase the amplification is basically the image gets brighter and brighter. So it's not that the image gets more light or there is more light coming into the lens or more light to the sensor. Whatever light is there is amplified or it's made brighter. So that's what ISO actually is, and that's how ISO actually works. And now, since we've talked about ISO, one thing that we have to understand that comes along with ISO is noise. To understand what noise is, let's again go back to that old example of the mic and the speaker. There again, beyond a point, when we increase the volume, there will be a lot of disturbances in the sound that's coming out from the speaker. These disturbances come because we've applied amplification on the signal so much that there is a lot of noise or there is a lot of unwanted disturbances that creep into the signal. This same concept is what happens when we increase the ISO also. So when we push the ISO to a huge extent, what happens is the amplification that is applied on this electrical signal becomes so much, and there is a lot of noise that comes into the image, and the image becomes grainy and noisy, and it has those color aberrations and all of those things. So that's what noise is, and that's how noise comes into your image. As you increase the ISO, the amount of noise that's going to come into your signal or your image is going to be also more. So as the more the ISO, the more the noise is going to be in your image. So now there are a lot of new cameras out there that say that they are good at low light and things like that. So what does that actually mean? It means that for those cameras, what they do with the images, even when you are at a high ISO, they have algorithms working in the camera to reduce the noise. they've understood how noise creeps into that image and they reduce that noise. So yeah, so this is it. So this is what ISO is. And if you have any doubts or queries, you can hit me up in the comment box and we can together find answers for those. So yeah, that's it guys. So bye guys. Yeah.